We get set to be inspired by our next guest. Spencer West had his legs amputated at the age of 5, and now he has released a book about his life. Standing Tall deals with many of the themes that we can all relate to: bullying, finding the meaning in life, and courage. And today, Spencer's here to tell us all about it. So thank you so much for coming in.
It's my pleasure. Thanks for having me.
Okay, so we'll start sort of at the beginning of your journey with an amputation at age 5. Mm-hmm. Tell us what led to that.
Yeah, I was born with a genetic disease that caused the muscles in my legs not to work. So we figured it might be a little bit easier if we removed them so I could get around better. So that's sort of where that began. And afterwards, I was told that I might not ever sit up by myself or walk by myself or be a functioning member of society. But we sort of tried to prove that wrong. Mm-hmm.
So at age 5, do you remember making those decisions, or was it mostly your parents at that point?
It was mostly my parents. I mean, I was involved, and it was something that we talked about, but in my mind, it was like, this is going to make life so much easier, mm-hmm. so let's just do it.
Nice. Okay, yeah. And you've gone on to prove that.
Yeah, I hope so.
That it's worked. Okay, and now you've been inspired to write a book. What is that all about?
You know, I'm really lucky. I work for MeToWe as a motivational speaker, and I have about an hour to tell a little bit about my story, but it's not enough to really highlight the amazing people who also supported me in getting me to where I am today. So I wanted to be able to share a little bit more about my story, but also my incredible family and mentors who were such a huge part of my journey. So this is sort of an homage to them as well.
Mm-hmm. And some of the themes are bullying and looking for meaning in life. What sort of things have you encountered along the way?
Yeah, you know, being different came with a bunch of challenges, societal and as well as in school for looking different and getting out into the real world and what that was like as well. So I wanted to hopefully use these experiences to inspire other people to overcome their obstacles and understand that every challenge has a lesson, and that's really important for us to start recognizing those and to be able to take risks in order to learn some of those lessons.
Mm-hmm. So if you were to talk to a child now about bullying and being different, what would you tell them to sort of help them get through that time?
I think the first thing is that they're not alone. I think this is something that is still happening in schools all across North America, mm-hmm. and the rest of the world. But I think it's important to recognize that you need to talk about it. You need to have a safe space or support network for you to express those feelings, and if you need help, to ask for help as well. So I think that's sort of where I would start.
Okay. You also mentioned challenges. You have your own challenge coming up. A huge one. You're going to climb Mount Kilimanjaro in this upcoming June.
Yeah. I was really lucky. I've had the opportunity to visit Kenya multiple times through MeToWe, and they really captured my heart. And as we all know, the drought in East Africa is huge, and I wanted to be able to give back a little bit. So my best friends and I are going to climb Mount Kilimanjaro this summer in hopes to raise money to go towards drought relief through our best friend organization, Free the Children.
Fantastic. And you've been there before. You've been to India and Africa. What sort of things are you doing while you're there? Is it more of the same, sort of sharing your story and trying to motivate kids around the world?
While I'm there, I'm a leadership facilitator. So I'm typically with students from all over North America, and we're volunteering and building a school and sort of leading them through the process that I went when I went to Kenya 3 years ago.
Mm-hmm. Yeah. A fantastic process.
Thank you.
You also, we mentioned the meaning of life in the book. Do you think you found that yet? Are you still searching?
I don't know if we'll ever really know. Mm-hmm. I'm on this journey, and I think I'm going in the right direction, but who knows what'll happen in the next little bit. I've sort of learned to just roll with it and take the paths that we're supposed to take and hopefully find our way back if we get lost. So.
True enough. So what's next? Kilimanjaro? Have you looked beyond that?
Yeah. You know, through MeToWe, we have a big event coming up called We Day that's happening in Vancouver on October 13th. Mm-hmm. So I'm really excited about that as well. So to be back on the West Coast and to be a part of that also.
Okay. What's that about?
We Day is basically, it's a movement, but more than it's like a rock concert for social change.
Yes. Okay.
Yeah. For people to come together and recognize the power they have to change the world.
I do recall that when you mentioned rock concert, I remember seeing it over the course of the years. Okay. So if people need to follow you on Free the Children, that's your trip to Kilimanjaro.
Yes.
FreeTheChildren.com is where you can find that information. Mm-hmm. And what about the book, Standing Tall?
Yeah, it's so exciting. The book is available in Indigos and Chapters across Canada and other bookstores, or at our website at MeToWe.com.
All right. Yeah. So MeToWe.com. And if you lost all of that, you can find all the links that you need to know on our website, and then simply click on News Links. So thank you so much for coming
awesome.
And sharing your story.
Thank you. It's such a pleasure.
And we're back right after the break.